Anyway, it'll end up as two YouTube videos. Hi, chat. Welcome to the stream. What about your face? I mean, no, I don't use that either. I don't use face unlock. Yeah. I don't use face unlock. All right, we're gonna start stream by turning off my computer. Okay, open source Python programming. What are we gonna work on today, chat? Oh look, the chatbot's here. Oh, today's January 31st is true. What do you use, pin? Which numbers? Obviously my pin is 1234, right? What other pin would you use? 1234 is the best pin. I bet that's your pin, Kramer SB. Oh, 12345? Damn it, Allcliffs. Man, you've got a much better pin than I do. Infinitely more secure. Isn't your fingerprint more secure? Yeah, but I don't want to give that away. I have no problems giving away 1234. So I have no problems giving away bad password also. Oh no, you can have my password. It's bad password. Don't give away your finger? Yeah. And giving away your finger would be much worse. Seems buggy. Yeah, my brother's code is buggy. Yeah. You say, man, an old work laptop and the password missing. I chat around to 123. Nice. Okay, so I don't have a plan for today. I don't know what I'm going to work on. I haven't really set anything up yet. But I do know that the Ruby guy got back to me. And so I started looking into that. It turns out it is just as simple as they had stated. As we had found. We had already found this answer. I wasn't sure if they were doing anything else special. But they just run rvm install ruby version -- movable. So I want to figure out what this does and if it's RVM specific and if it's complicated. I hope it's not. I hope it's just a configure flag. I hope this just gets translated into something. But we're going to try and figure that one out. And yeah. But Anthony, they store an encrypted, only decryptable by your device copy of your fingerprint to use, and you can totally trust that. Yeah, I don't trust that. GBGSH or something else for sign commits? Sign commits is a waste of time. I don't do any of that. Because when's the last time you actually verified someone's signature? Never. Fucking never. And how much of a pain in the ass was it to set up GBG keys? Still work. Infinite work. SSH signing, fine. If it's trivial and I don't have to do anything to make it happen, fine. But anything else, you know, if I have to do an extra step to sign my commits, not fucking worth it. Okay, anyway, let's figure out what this movable thing does. Oh, we can turn on the Pokemon too. Yeah. We try and enforce sign commits at work, mostly to make it hard as fuck for people to do work outside of a work computer. Yeah. Increase the barrier to entry. Oh, what the fuck? This isn't my playlist. Why didn't... What? Oh, I know why. It got to the end of the playlist, and then YouTube does this dumb thing where... If you have autoplay on, even if you have loop playlist, it'll just be like, no, I don't think I will. Graham's iPad, thank you for the resub at 2-3. Fancy, fancy. At 28 months, holy shit, good to see you again. Hopefully you're doing well. But yeah, using requiring sign commits at work just so that it's a pain to copy your keys elsewhere. Yeah. You just zip your changes to email your work email? Yeah, 100%. That's how we make all of our commits, is we email patches back and forth. Like God and Linus intended. All right, RVM depth equals one. There's something a little bit funny about about saying God and Linus. Okay. Movable. Ah, there's not much that is used here. Where is the actual cod that uses this? Scripts cly. Movable. RVM movable flag. RVM disable binary flag. This probably just means it doesn't do pre-built. This is probably the thing we actually care about. RVM movable flag. Okay, that's where it gets set. RVM setup compile environment movable early. Stone tablets immutable storage used by God. The stone tablets aren't immutable. So no. Well, then he says, did you finally get the RVM build tools? Yeah, it turns out that it's simple. It's just these things. But I want to see if I can do without RVM. I wanna see what makes this tick. What make this tick? Okay, BSD not supported. Cool. Darwin. Ruby 2, 3 in head, it's fine. Otherwise allow you to force. Okay. Blah blah blah. This is just a version check thing. Cool. Got it. Great. Oh boy. Okay, this is the magic. This is the magic. This is the magic. Okay, it looks like it sits. Enable load relative on all OSs, but on Mac OS it sets with static linked ext. Without ext. Without Windows, tkinter, and some other garbage. Okay. And it also patches something. Might have to look at that. Happy Philomel. Thank you for the follow. Welcome. Hopefully you're doing well. Immutable in a sense that they haven't changed since the original writing? Well. You don't know that. Okay, so in theory, we can build Ruby with this flag, zip it up and move it, and it should work, is what this is saying. I hate Ruby. Why am I... Oh, I made a new thing, by the way, chat. So, I'll show you. Pre-commit. So... I was looking at, why do I have discussions enabled? How do I turn? Excuse me. Does it show that if it's not my repo? Print. Oh, okay. It's only visible to me. Some fucking product manager was like, they're gonna click on this and be like, why is it here? Oh, you can get started now. EasyLight, hello. Not Yan. What's wrong with your VS Code? Krimisby says it's fine. Not Yan, what's wrong with you? Click not now, we need to know what'll happen. I'm pretty sure it does nothing. I'm pretty sure it probably just takes you back to... Oh, it does actually get rid of it. Look at that. Look at that. It does actually... I'm surprised. I expected it to do nothing. It's still gone even if I refresh. I'm surprised. Edit pins. Oh. Oh, you can do private pins? I was wondering if I could private pin. Because I want to pin this. Private pins. As much as I don't like pinned repos. Oh. Well, where's the other ones? I just spit on my mic. What are the public pins? Oh, now I can't see the public pins? Frequency I and issues. Yeah, okay, I'll pin those as private and public, maybe? You would think that the private ones would just inherit the public ones, but no, we can't have nice things, can we? Pins and private. Oh. Uh-huh. Yes, so now if I go here, it should have all three of the pins, but in a weird order. There we go. Okay, cool. Cool. XX.codes, thank you for the follow. Welcome. The freaking product managers are fuckers. Stop trying to make me change. Yeah,
I don't know why they do that. Well, I know why they do that.
Anyway, what I wanted to show you is if we look at the main... Wait, what is the release workflow? Oh, someone added a workflow in a PR that I said no to. Bye. If we look at the main workflow, we have a filter to branch main. We go back a few patches, such as this one, and we look at Windows. And the first step of the job is to run checkout. Why the fuck does it take 20 seconds to get clone? I asked myself. So I made a repo where I was like, surely it doesn't take 20 seconds to clone Prigamint, even on Windows. So I set up a repo, and I set up a GitHub action that just runs checkout of itself, and then get clone with depth one, and then get clone of Prigamint with depth one. Should be the same. Should all be the same. The default of checkout is depth one also. So it should be apples to apples. And we'll run this. We see that checkout of this empty fucking repo takes 11 seconds. But when I ran it with set-x, it took 600 milliseconds to do this and 800 milliseconds to do pre-commit. Which makes sense. Pre-commit's a little bit chunkier than this, but... Something that's that should be 800 milliseconds is somehow taking 20 fucking seconds. And so I was like, okay, this is probably some JavaScript bullshit fuckery going on in here. I'm going to write my own checkout and see how slow it is. And annoyingly, even after I wrote my own checkout, which just calls get clone, it's still kind of slow, but it's faster at least. Now, well, the other one I ran took only 9 seconds, but 14 seconds is better than 20, and most of the ones I was seeing were like 35 plus. Demon Barak, thank you for the follow. Welcome. Paris product managers are still people like us, and Stonkfish says wrong. I didn't, Stonkfish. So this is still not as fast, and I don't know why. Let's see, raw log. Yeah, so it starts this action at 35:49. Yeah, and then somehow this shell script takes a whole 15 seconds, which makes no sense to me. Something is taking a long time for some reason. Let me try and clone Prigamint on my Raspberry Pi. It should be much faster. Maybe because it's a step. Yeah, GitHub probably does some like bullshit. But that would mean that every step would be like that. Like this step is 0 seconds. But this definitely does work. So I don't know. There's something fishy going on there. Something fishy going on there. But shmeep shmop. I don't know. I don't know. But I made it faster, so I cut 10 to 20 seconds off of every pre-commit CI run or pre-commit run. Doesn't super matter because this run takes almost 30 minutes right now. I'll be fixing that too. Okay, Ruby stuff. I want to use RBMV to build these because, well, there's a thing called Ruby Build. And they've, in theory, thought of all the smart things that I don't have to think about. It's 0.4% of the runtime? Yeah. But on other things, it's much more. Probably use some ARM platforms for GitHub. I wish they used ARM. No, GitHub Actions is still stuck in x86. If they used ARM, a lot of stuff would be way simpler. And currently, we have all these like really terrible cross builds that take fucking forever. I'm hungry, chat. Maybe I shouldn't have continued to stream. Maybe I should have just gotten food. I don't have my cooking set up yet. Annoyingly. Blah blah blah. Usage blah. Prerequisite libraries. Here we go. macOS don't care. What the fuck is this? What the hell? Well, we don't really care. Ubuntu. Roost! What is YJIT? Oh, this is the shit that they were like. This is the Ruby 3 thing. Cite us in your paper. Interesting. Roost. Okay, so we're gonna need a whole bunch of stuff, I guess. This is a good starter point. Docker file from Ubuntu. Jammy. We'll probably build these for a bunch of architectures, but we'll start with Jammy. Jammy. Apt. Debian frontend equals null interactive. Apt-get. Oh! Look. Oh! Damn, everything moved all at once. Apt-get install dash y no install recommends. Oh, it's moving the Pokemon over. I wonder how many Pokemon it actually picked up, because it's definitely buggy. Oh, which means I have to either fix my brother's patch or have him fix it himself. Rust C! What version of Rust C ships here? Apt-cache show Rust C. 158.1. Oh, 161.0. I'm surprised that they upgraded this. That seems new enough. We'll have to probably figure out if we ship for other operating system versions, we'll have to figure out how to get them a roost. God damn, there's a lot of libraries here. Libmen curses 5. That doesn't sound right. I'm pretty sure that's a virtual package now. Libmen curses 5-dev. Yeah, it's not a thing. Oh, wait. Oh, it is a thing. Is this the transitional package? Transitional package, yeah. It should be libmcurses-dev. We'll get the right version. But I think I also want W? Oh, maybe they've been joined together. So let's do that. FFI GDM6. Weird that both the dev and non-dev headers are added there, but that's fine. var lib apt-list star. Okay, and then sort this bad boy. Pizza says, what's your favorite dish? Like, what's my favorite food? My favorite food is probably sushi. But I don't think I'm gonna have sushi tonight. I haven't had sushi in a very long time, actually. It says, it's 4 months into a job as an architect, too soon to suggest moving to AWS from Azure, asking for a friend. Damn. Yeah, I mean, I feel ya there. Good sushi Sunday night. I feel like it's weird that you've capitalized the word sushi in every message that you've talked about sushi. What's up with that, DDalsp? Why capital? MTDev.net! Hello, how you doing? AWS is easier. Thank you for the resub in 12 months, which gets you a fancy new badge. Congrats on 1 year. Sush, says Stonkfish. Yes. Lestush. I get so used to capitalizing S's. Because of pseudo? Oh, snap logic? Oh, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Upgrading Ruby build. What? I must have missed a step. Surely I just cloned this thing, right?
We're not going to be using... I think we can use it standalone.
Yeah, it looks like we just cloned this repo. So we're going to also add git and CA certificates here. And git, and we'll probably need Python. And we might as well add curl. That seems like a good old Docker file. Docker build dash t ruby junk. Dot. Recover? Yeah. Yeah. What if you ran a Docker build inside GitHub Actions if your checkout would be faster? Your logic makes no sense, Allcliffs. Can you add the redeems back? Yeah. Can they do that? Blurp, 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 blurp. Enable. Oh, nope, don't want that one enabled. Okay, good, no one done it. Pizza says, looking for a previous stream. Can't find them on Twitch. Yeah, I switched to YouTube only VODs because Twitch was sending me spooky emails about DMCA, and I was like, well, don't really want to deal with that problem. Okay, I gotta look at my face for a sec. Well, I password. All right, we're good now. Back to here, type eraser. There we go. Copy you, copy that, and easy mode. Okay. No, I don't want premium type racer. All right, chat, make sure to click join, and we will be doing some type racer race rings. Link is in the chat. Oh, I almost forgot to click join. They changed the font too, which is interesting. They still haven't fixed the link problem.
Instead of using like action checkout, you can specify a Docker.
Yeah, if you a Docker image is always going to be slower than literally anything else. Well, that was a dark fucking message. Did she give you free premium for all the advertising? Yeah. She says, have you tried the HHKB? No, I've not. I don't know what that is, but I have not. Frightened is annoying to type? Yeah. A lot of those words were annoying to type. Like, gotta? Gotta was in there, I think? Yeah. Whispering. Marsha isn't here, we have a chance? Yeah. Are you trying to beat me once, Wolfred? Is that your goal? That was depressing, right, Andracosta? What a fucking set of phrase. It was a thing. It was a thing. Okay. Ugh, there's a bunch of grumbly words in this one, too. They have merch, do they? That's funny. What the fuck is that word? Veranda. I choked at the end! No! Where's that period? No, fucking A. Dude, I choked so hard. I choked so hard at the end. Ugh. I was like 100-ish and then blarp 45. Dude, so many of those words were shitty. Veranda? I don't even think this is spelled right. Storytelling cassette curfews. I also went climbing today, so my hands are all slimy and my fingers are grumbly. Yeah, that's just excuses. That's just copium. Right, we're going to do one more. I can't end on an 88. Is that a 0 or an O? I think it's an O. I hope it's an O. Oh my god, this one's a bad one too. Ugh, we pulled it out from the end though. That semicolon though, I was ready on that one. I was ready on the semicolon. I've written too much code with semicolons. Textboard says, literally watching this sitting on my veranda. I feel like it's not spelled like that. I feel like the H isn't there. Yeah, the H is not there. The H does not exist there. Yeah, the H must be a British spelling. This is the spelling that I'm familiar with. Steve Extreme! Thank you for the follow. Welcome, welcome. Hopefully you're doing well. Like, where's the H popularized? H variant. Wait, this form is correct and very common. Very common, okay. Anyway. Can the way. You spell with an H if you're a Jane Austen novel. You had the H in India? I see. You have a trackball mouse and my ball is fucked up. Well, good thing I don't have a trackball mouse. Oh, what the fuck? Can you hear that? This ball is fucked up. Making the bearings are fucked. It sounds like it's grumbling. It's very loud. What happened to you? Hang on, let me blow on my ball. Yeah, it's fucked. Oh, that's sad. Why don't we get another one? That's really annoying. Game Boy cartridge didn't work. This one at least is fine. Ooh, I snapped. Did like a one-hand clap there. I had a friend who could really, really, he was really good at one-hand clapping. I was always jealous. But it's such a stupid, stupid human trick. Ruby junk bash. What is your repository? RBM / Ruby build. Alright, so I probably could have depth one that guy. Bin Ruby build help. Ooh, okay. Definition prefix. Okay, is there a way to do custom options? Oh, look at that. Ruby configure opts.
Is that an RBM thing or is that a Ruby thing?
Or is that a Ruby build thing? Blah, 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 blah. Surely there's like an environment variables thing, right? Environment. Oh, here we go. Custom builds. Here we go. There, configure ops? Why aren't you prefixed? Anemic Prince, thank you for the follow. Welcome, welcome. Hopefully you're doing well. All right, let's try this. So, configure ops equals, what was the RVM thing? Enable load relative, sysconfter equals, let's see, bin ruby build. What version should we use? What is latest Ruby version? Ruby downloads. 320. Oh, duh. put this in quotes. What am I doing? Prefix. Definition prefix. Weird prefix. Working. It's working. Do you ever clone wikis? If so, do you store them in the main repo directory or outside of it? There is a Ruby configure ops too. It applies only to Ruby source. Huh. Well, we're gonna use this one. How much longer stream? I don't know. I'm kind of hungry. I also don't know how long this second stream is. Been like, this is gonna be like a 30-minute VOD. Gym is tomorrow. I went to the gym today. Oh, I got a really bad bruise. Cause I shinned a volume. Ugh. But I'm sure it'll get better. Copium. What is it doing? Was I supposed to add like J8 somewhere? It might be doing, there's multiple CC1 processes, so it might be, it looks like it's J5. Like it's doing the right thing. Transition to a cooking stream, but yeah, but I don't know my cooking stream set up. I read your question, but I don't know what you mean. The wiki repos have a different URL. I almost never clone them. I usually disable the wiki. I have one repo where the wiki is enabled. Which is my Scratch repo. And that's only because I use it for the planes list. And I used to use it for like links I would send people. But I haven't done that in a while. Eggs, eggs, eggs. CPU goes burr. Yeah, this is taking a very long time. I wish it showed the output. I probably could have done it with verbose. Oh. Default. A fucking idiot. Just do what it tells you to do. Exec. That's what I wanted, of course. Tail dash if this. Hey. Why is it exactly 999? That makes a little suspicious. Metal Storm, hello. How you doing? It is oddly satisfying that it's exactly 999. It's also weird that it's showing up in chunks. Like there's some sort of weird buffering going on. And it's not like five file chunks. Oh, it's documentation stuff. Okay, yeah, it's definitely standard IO buffering. But in a weird way. I should have built it without the docs. I'm not gonna distribute docs. But anyway, this is just an attempt to see if I can move a Ruby. Oh, it's doing them again. But we already got to 100%. What is it doing now? Do we even know what process is doing that? Ruby. Huh. Mm-hmm. But I guess that means that it exists, right? That it's functional. Then I just need to automate this process and, well, assuming it works. I don't even know. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure it works because the pregnant test worked.
God, do I really want to become the person that builds Rubies and Pythons?
Not really. Wish I could just be someone who actually cares about this problem. I don't. Oh, it's done. Prefix bin Ruby version. Okay, cool. If we move prefix to prefix 2, and then I do prefix bin Ruby version, it still succeeds. But last time we had problem when I did prefix bin IRB. Whoa! New game, you just hold down tab and see what Ruby does? What is going on? I don't think I can require thread error, but it seems to be working. Also, I like how there's just like random leftover text down here. SSL is the thing, right? What is a fucking, I don't know. What is a Ruby module? I don't know any Ruby modules.
Oh,
libruby gems. Gems again. Rake. PP. We're going to require PP. What are you, PP? False. What does that mean? PP. PP? PP. PP, PP. Seems to work. We have acquired the PP. Akin Fenwa. Hello, hello. Welcome. Wow, how did you know the Pokemon command? I'm impressed. Dead Gems Repo coming soon? Yeah, kind of. Yeah, that's kind of the idea. But it's not for Ubuntu. This would be for all sorts of other stuff. You guessed it! Nice, nice. PP is required by default. Require false means it didn't load anything new. Ah, so we need to find something else. Require CSV. True. And then false. I see. I understand. Cool, cool. Last time I used Ruby was when I was poking at the GitHub source code. Did they have a leak or did you work at GitHub? Or was this some of their open source code? Thank you, Godison. Appreciate that. I'm guessing PP is a pretty printer, but there's also something called pretty print, so now I don't know. But it's also interesting to me that Ruby distributes a bunch of Ruby gems
by default.
Which is interesting. This is the other one that I was concerned about. Needs to work though. No certain size on the Nuda junk output. Have you seen this before in Nano? I haven't used Nano in a while. Let's see. No, I have not seen this before, but that's pretty fucking funny. Windows RDP, Windows SSH, Ubuntu with Zeesh. That's pretty well. Does it do it with Babby? Clear fixes it until the next command. Yeah, I got no idea. I don't know, man. Okay. I think that shows that this idea works. So then I gotta build all the infrastructure on this. But I am too hungry to think. So unfortunately, we're going to cut the stream short today. And we'll continue on this soon. You know what Babby is. You're probably just triggering the bot, right? Surely. But yeah, that's going to wrap us up for today. My name is Anthony. That's the wrong link. I upload educational content to my YouTube channel 3 times a week at youtube.com/anthonywritescode. So subscribe there and find those. My stream VODs are no longer going to Twitch because of DMCA stuff. So now they are available at youtube.com/@anthonywritescode-vods. So you can find stream VODs there. Also, another announcement. On Thursday, I'm going to be streaming with Juicebox Hero, and we are going to continue on our code teaching series where we're going to be learning some Python stuff. We are now on episode 6. 6? Something like that? I have no fucking idea what we're going to learn. Probably we're going to start with functions. Yeah, we'll do functions. Because we learned strings. A whole bunch of junk about strings. We're probably going to learn some functions. Yeah, that seems fine. Anyway, that'll happen on this Thursday. I don't know what time it is. Look at her Twitter. It says there. I just follow the leader. What else? Oh, I normally stream on Monday evenings and Saturday at noon. I announce my streams in 2 places. One of those is Lay Twitter, where I announce what I'm going to do. And then we do. The other is the Discord, which you are free to join and come hang out with us. The booty call receiver, yeah. yep, that's me. Twitter, I'd rather not get a Twitch notification for 15 minutes. Well, then join the Discord. Discord's probably the better place. But yeah. Anyway, that's gonna wrap us up. Let's go find someone to raid.